action figure enthusiasts out there. JC here, and today I'm coming at you with a news video, which I'm going to try and keep pretty short, though there is quite a bit to go over. I haven't done a video at all this week. I do apologize for that, but it's just been one of those weeks, and I'm not even talking about all the craziness with the coronavirus that certainly has contributed to things. But just to give you a brief summary, Monday I had to start the week off saying goodbye to my dog Molly. She was 12 years old. She had been battling cancer since last November, and she had been giving a pretty good fight of it. But in the last month or so, there had been a decline, and unfortunately, we just got to that point where we had to say goodbye to her. So that was definitely a hard thing to do on Monday for me. And then on Tuesday, there's this field that's near my house that caught on fire, a brush fire. It was a windy day, and I don't know what happened, if somebody, dropped a match, a cigarette, or what have you, but, the field caught on fire. It was really kind of interesting to watch, the flames just, spread like wildfire. I mean, now I know what that saying means, and the flames actually got somewhat close to the house. I mean, we weren't in any real danger. The fire department got out here pretty quickly and everything, but definitely it made Tuesday to be an interesting day. And then with everything that's just been going on over the last several days over the coronavirus, all the cancellations, schools being canceled, sporting events being canceled, events like the E3 video game convention have been canceled. WonderCon has been postponed. They have not made a decision on San Diego yet. I'm guessing they're waiting until we get a little closer to July before they make a decision. Fully expect, unless there's some major change on the coronavirus front, unless they develop a vaccine much sooner than they anticipated, I am still expecting pretty much any convention or anything that requires a large gathering to be canceled this year, including San Diego Comic Con. So we'll have to wait and see for sure. Again, they have not made a final decision on San Diego, but the WonderCon convention, which they also, the same people who do San Diego do WonderCon in Anaheim, California, and that one has been postponed. And then other events, we're still waiting to hear what Vince McMahon and the WWE are going to do with WrestleMania. They just announced SmackDown that comes on tonight is not going to have an audience. So I really don't see how WrestleMania is going to go forward. It's in Tampa, Florida this year. Everything else in Florida is being canceled. I really don't see how they're going to go forward. Business as usual with WrestleMania. But again, we're still waiting on an official announcement for that. But enough about coronavirus. I'm sure you've been bombarded. Every time you turn on the news, you're bombarded about it. And so let's talk about a few other things, toy-related stuff. Four new products that have been announced over the past week. First of all, I want to talk about NECA Toys. They announced that they're doing several new crates, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle-based loot crates. They've been doing the loot crate stuff. The guy who owns NECA actually ended up buying Loot Crate as well. That's why you see so many collaborations between the two companies. They're doing three different crates. Each one is going to have an exclusive Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle figure to it. The first one they're doing is based on the Mirage Comics. It's going to have a Shredder figure, which they've released an image of. Then there's going to be one based on the video game and a third one on the animated series. And those also will have figures, though they have not actually revealed what those figures are. And then if you get all three crates, which are costing close to about $50 each, and there'll be other things included in the crates, not just the action figures. But if you get all three, then you'll have access to a fourth figure, which is said to be a Bebop figure wearing a bunny suit from one of the episodes of the old cartoon. But it is a different version of Bebop that they're going to be releasing through this. Now, if you still haven't gotten your hands on the Rocksteady Bebop 2-pack, the Target exclusive, that has been shipping in more numbers to stores. It was briefly online for a few minutes the other day. I once again missed out. I checked my local Target. They had no Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle sets. And again, unfortunately, I just don't have time to go on a daily basis hoping I can find this set. So I still think they need to really get this out in greater number, especially online, if they really want to make this viable for most people, because I understand that in large part I don't put much of the blame on this on NECA. It's probably more Target than anything, but still, it's very frustrating. Even with them shipping out more of these, it's still very frustrating, I think, for the majority of people trying to collect this line. And it's unfortunate because it's such an awesome line. I think they're giving us a lot of great figures. They showed off a lot of great stuff at Toy Fair. So I really do hope that they continue to get that stuff out and in greater numbers so that pretty much anyone who wants to get their hands on those figures can do so without having to pay secondary market prices. For you Tomasi Nation SH Figure Art fans of Dragon Ball, they revealed a new figure that's going to be on display at this weekend's La Mole convention, Comic-Con convention in Mexico City. It is Final Battle Jiren. No other details at this time. But again, that figure is on the way from Tomasi Nations. Hot Toys just today released images for a new Arkham Knight figure, this time Batgirl. This figure is said to feature a newly developed masthead sculpt with fabric type hair, the long light brown hair. And then she's also going to have a new developed body tailored for Batgirl and the bat suit, of course, with the gold bat logo on it. She's going to come with a number of accessories, bat gadgets, including a grapple gun, bat claw, batarangs, a remote hacking device, and then the figure is also going to have a specially designed flight stand to go with it. So if you're a Batgirl fan, this is one that you're going to want to check out. It was just announced today and probably will be going up for pre-order at places like our sponsor Big Bad Toy Store in the next few days, probably by Monday at the latest. For you McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse fans, we've got some new figure listings. These come via the EB Games computer system. They've not been officially confirmed by McFarlane Toys. A big shout out to KNR for the heads up on these. And again, like I said, do treat these as rumors, as McFarlane Toys, at least at this time, have not yet confirmed these. A number of these figures look to be based on the Dark Knight's metal figures. So I think, you know, the Batman Who Laughs figure was pretty popular in the first wave. But the listings are as followed. So we're going to be getting Dawnbreaker, which looks like is going to be released in August. Devastator, which is actually listed as a normal figure. It's not like a Build-A-Figure or a deluxe figure. It should have the same $20 price range as the regular figures. We're getting Flashpoint Batman, Grim Knight, Modern Flash, and Modern Flash is due out in October. The others are slated with August release dates. A Modern Joker figure, a Murder Machine figure, and again, that one's going to be out in August. Red Death, again, August. Red Hood, that's got an October release date. And then there's also a listing for a new vehicle with a figure. I have no idea what the figure is or what the vehicle is, but it looks like that's going to cost in the neighborhood of $50. Oh, and going back to Hot Toys real quick, they also earlier in the week announced that they're doing another Harley Quinn figure based on the Birds of Prey movie. Even though the movie itself didn't do very good at the box office, they are doing a second figure. This one is listed as Harley the Jacket version. So she's got this weird looking jacket with all the tassels and everything. I haven't seen the movie yet, but I'm assuming this is something she actually wears in the movie. You get some weapons, you get a bat, you get some ammo, you get multiple pairs of hands, and you get a stand with it. And that one, I believe, last time I checked, I think that one is available for pre-order now at places like our sponsor, Big Bad Toy Store. For you Star Wars fans, we got a confirmation of a rumor I told you about in the last news video with another Gaming Greats Black Series figure. I told you how there was going to be a second figure from the Force Unleashed video game coming, a Shadow Stormtrooper, and now we've got an image that surfaced on social media this week giving us our first look at the actual figure, and it does have some translucent parts. I had mentioned I hope they included some translucent parts with it, with the blue highlights, which looks like is what they have done with it. This figure should be available. Again, it's part of the Gaming Greats line, which have been exclusive to EB Games in Canada and GameStop here in the United States. Now, the first figure, if you haven't been keeping up, is a Stormtrooper Commander that I've talked about previously. It was also based on the Force Unleashed video game. That one is definitely already hitting EB Games, and this one probably will be out soon. Okay, and then on the Marvel front, really don't have a whole lot new for you. Just a few more listings that come via that Canadian distributor, Everest. So they've been posting a lot of stuff. Unfortunately, most of the stuff they list have code names or are very vague in their description, so I can't tell you for sure. But I just wanted to point out that they're listing a Marvel Legends Spider-Man Build-A-Figure Redeco figure, which I'm guessing is going to be the Kingpin. I talked about how there had been rumors of a Kingpin figure, Redeco figure coming as a fan channel exclusive, so my best guess is that's what this is referring to. I have no idea exactly what the Kingpin is going to look like. Obviously, it's going to be a repaint of the Build-A-Figure that had the white suit. Will it be a black suit Kingpin? Will it be a purple pants Kingpin from the animated series? Which I could see that, with the retro card. But again, I really have no specific details. But there should be a Kingpin redeco coming, and likely that's what this is referring to. And then they also listed three other Spider-Man fan channel exclusive figures. Again, no specific details or anything. I'm guessing one of those is going to be the Mysterio figure, which again was previously rumored, possibly on a retro card with a few minor alterations to the regular version they did. But again, I don't have any specifics. And then I have absolutely no idea what the other two figures they are listing. You'll notice two say TV, which I'm thinking are in reference to the classic animated series. They're doing the entire retro line, which has actually been listed on there as well. So they have code names for those, but they do show that that wave is going to have six figures. So we can now looks pretty good that the rumors of the wave. We know three of the figures. They announced those at Toy Fair with the Peter Parker, the Gwen Stacy with the Mary Jane alternate head, and then the Spider-Man figure that is newly sculpted. And then the three remaining figures rumored for that wave are Daredevil, some version of Daredevil. I'm hoping the armored version of Daredevil, and then a Green Goblin figure and an Electro figure. So those are the three remaining figures, and it definitely looks like the wave is going to have six figures in it. And then the final thing that showed up is our first product based on the Falcon and Winter Soldier Disney Plus series. It is a Legends Captain America shield, so probably they're going to take the movie shield that they released previously and make some minor changes to it, I guess. We'll have to wait and see, but that is our first official listing for one of the Disney Plus series products for the Disney Plus series. I'm sure there's a lot more that's going to be coming, especially with Marvel Legends, but we'll have to wait and see. Okay, so that's it for today. I'd love to hear your thoughts on everything I talked about. Let me know in the comments section below. As always, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Hit the bell notification. Stay safe out there. It's getting crazier every day, so do please stay safe. And until next time, guys, I'll catch you later.
Hey, thanks for watching today's video, and be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and hit that bell notification to alert it every time I upload a new video. And be sure to head over to the Toy News International and Marvelous News message boards communities. It's a great place to talk toys and win cool contests like $100 store credits to Big Bad Toy Store. And remember, action figures are great.